Take it away.
Okay, so I'm going to talk about why and how to wrap your horse's legs. I chose this topic because I'm really surprised by how many people own horses and don't know how to wrap legs or don't know how to do it correctly. And I think if you're going to be around horses a lot, it's something that's really important to know how to do. So there's two types of wraps that I'm going to talk about today. The first is polo wraps, which are mainly used during exercise, and they provide protection and support to your horse's legs. And the second are standing wraps, which you can use like after exercise or injury, or like if you're going to trail them somewhere, you can use them to protect the legs during transport. Some people like will say that they don't need to know how to do wraps because they use boots instead of polo wraps, which I use boots pretty frequently. I prefer them because I just think they take less time and they provide the same amount of protection. But if you ever don't have them, or if it's the only thing available and you need to know how to do polos, I think it's important to know.
Because if something happens unexpectedly, you should always know more than one way to do something.
Right. And then standing wraps, I think everyone should know how to do these, just because if your horse ever gets hurt or something and has to have a wrap on, it's good to know how to do it yourself. So for polo wraps, sometimes like just getting them ready to wrap is like half the battle of doing these. So when you wrap them up, you want to start by holding the Velcro and making sure that you wrap it to the inside, like the Velcro is going to be on the inside of the wrap. And you want to wrap it up as tight as possible. So the one on the right is what you want to apply. The one on the left is way too loose, and you're going to have a really difficult time getting it tight enough without like bending your horse's tendon around and just messing everything up. And you always want to make sure that your horse's legs are clean and dry and that the wraps are clean. If you get dirt in there, it can cause sores from the wraps. So when you start wrapping, you want to start with the polo on the inside at the top of the cannon bone. You always want to start the wrap on the bone, not the tendon. And you want to put it so that if it slides around a little bit, like if it would slide around the leg, it would still be on the bone and not on the tendon.
Maybe draw the line with your laser pointer where the end of that wrap is.
Yeah, it starts right on the bone right there. So if it were to slip around, it would still slide onto bone. So it's not going to be pressing on their tendon. And you want to wrap, if you're on the left leg, counterclockwise, and if you're on the right leg, you do clockwise. Or another way to think of it is you wrap front to back. So you're always wrapping towards their hind legs when the wrap is coming toward you.
Mm, and that's the front right leg there.
Yes. Yes, so you're going to wrap clockwise on that side.
Okay.
And then...
Now, is there a good reason for that? I mean, otherwise it slips on the tendon? Is that what...
Okay. So when I do it, I usually start by doing one wrap around the top just to secure it before I start to move down the leg. And generally you want to move down in about like 1-inch increments. It kind of depends on how long your wrap is and how big your horse's leg is, but you always want to kind of layer it a little bit, like move down slowly. And when you're securing it, you always want to, you never want to pull the tendon, because you can bow your horse's tendons, and if you do that, you're doing way more harm than good. So you always want to pull, you want to keep even pressure, but if you need to tighten it a little bit, pull when it's on the bone, not on the tendon. But the main goal is just to keep the even, steady pressure as you move down the leg. And like I said, each wrap should cover about half the previous wrap.
Okay, now I got a question on that one. Did they start up as high as you recommend?
Yeah, they could have gone up a little bit more.
Okay, I was just seeing it. To me, it looks like it could go up a little higher.
Yeah, it probably could. And just another note, as you can see, if this person is squatting beside their horse, you never want to kneel down, or definitely don't ever sit down, because if your horse spooks or anything, they could be on top of you and you want to be able to get out of the way.
Like, yeah, for
I think
safety.
Sometimes people get too comfortable with their horses. Mm-hmm. Like just the other day, I got kicked, and it kind of woke me up to like, these are dangerous horses, and even if we think they're quiet, we need to be able to...
Yeah, I mean, that's a good recommendation with cattle, too. You're always, even no matter where you're working, you're always to the point where you can go back, because if you're on your knees, you're immobile. But if you're squatting like that, you can push back. And if you're close enough to the animal and the animal moves towards you, you can put your hand on the animal and it moves you away from it too, right? Rather than being underneath something, because, yeah, it's crazy.
Yeah. So when you get to the bottom of the leg, you kind of want to do like a figure eight around the fetlock in a will end up as like a little V shape on the front of their leg. That's just basically to provide support to the fetlock. And you want to make sure that there are no wrinkles in the wrap when it's all smooth and even. And then once you've done the figure eight and it's back onto the cannon bone part of the leg, you wrap back up just the same way that you wrap down, keeping it even pressure in about 1-inch increments. And then at the top, you're going to secure it with the Velcro. And when you're done, they should look like that. Those are pretty nicely done wraps.
Yeah, no, that's, and they follow your instructions about clockwise versus counterclockwise. On the left, you can see they went counterclockwise.
Yeah, you can.
Would that be true for the back too?
Yes.
Okay.
Yep. You can always tell because the Velcro will point like towards their tail. It's another way to think about it. And it's the same way as if you're putting on like splint boots, the Velcro always points towards the back. So the second type of wrap I'm going to talk about is standing wraps. And you can use these, like, I used them a lot for my horse. Like after we would run cross country, I would poultice his legs and then put standing wraps on the outside. And when I trailered him, I would use it for protection. So for this, you'll need a quilted wrap or a no-bow wrap, which is the white wrap, and then a standing bandage, which is the red one. And it looks similar to a polo, but the material is a little bit different and stretches a little bit more. And you'll want to wrap that one up the same way as the polo, in that you keep the Velcro on the inside and you wrap it up pretty tight. And as always, make sure that your horse's legs are clean and the wraps are clean.
In the counterclockwise, clockwise recommendation the same with that?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, so for these, you'll want to start again on the bone. That person in the first picture, I think it's just a little too close to the tendon for my preference. I would like a little more on the bone, but if it slips around, it'll probably be okay. And when you're wrapping it around, you want to kind of secure it, like in the second picture, with your hand on the bone just to keep it in place. And then you wrap front to back, clockwise on the right, counterclockwise on the left, just like with the polos. And then when you go to use the standing wrap, some people will start on the outside of the quilted wrap. I think it's a little bit easier to put the standing wrap a couple inches inside of the quilted wrap just to keep everything in place, but it really doesn't matter either way. It's not going to affect your horse. It's just whatever is easier for you. And for this one, you don't start at the very top. You start a couple inches down the leg. It doesn't really make a huge difference if it's in the middle or a little bit higher or lower. It's okay. And you want to unroll the bandage down the leg the same way as the polo, basically. These wraps generally stretch a little bit more, so you don't have to work quite as hard to keep it tight. You want to avoid making it too tight, so you can cut off circulation, and that would be bad, obviously. And for these, you don't have to do the V as much around the fetlock. You kind of just wrap it straight down, and it works out. If you want, like I generally leave a little bit of wrap, the quilted wrap, open on the bottom and the top, just a couple centimeters. It's really just preference. And then with these, you secure it the same way that you would secure the polo wrap.
So you went down all the way, but then you actually then went back up to the top.
Yeah.
And then that's where the Velcro is up there.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. And then when you're done, if you wrap all four legs, it should look like that.
Pretty. Ends up pretty. Questions, comments on wrapping legs. I mean, look at how many varied topics. And the next one is anesthetics and fish. I mean, this is, can you plan it like this? You cannot plan it like this.
Yes.
So just to clarify, you wrap them like to help after exercise, like kind of like a compression sock kind of thing?
Yeah, like for with the standing wraps, generally I would like to poultice my horse first and then put the wrap on the outside just to keep everything in place. And then the poultice will like draw out the heat and inflammation so that the next day, like, I did 3-day lifting for a while, so we would always do cross country and then the next day we would show jump, and it just helps their legs feel better. They're not swollen and sore the next day.
Is it kind of like compression socks in people? Do you know how anybody from, I don't have any of those, but does anybody know?
They usually use those to help prevent clotting.
Oh, to prevent
the legs.
Okay.
Yeah.
And yeah, like some people will put them on their horses that are in stalls just because they're in stalls.
Okay, I was just curious. Now, is everything that you showed us that you wrap, is that all reusable, or is there a part that you don't reuse ever?
You can reuse all of it. Usually you just wash it and make sure it's all clean.
Okay, so it's all washable, and
yeah,
the Velcro will last for a while. I'm sure after a while it wears out, but
right.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, because, and then do you, I mean, do all people, when they trail their horse, trailing, you know, because that's, getting horses in trailers can be incredible sometimes.
There are some people who use, like, boots, like Velcro boots that go on.
That's a quick thing?
Right. I prefer the wraps. I think it just keeps them more stable. But also, if you're going to be going on, like, a really long trailer ride, like 18 hours or something like that, you don't want to use them. It's more for, like, probably 10 hours or less, because you don't want the wrap to be on too long.
Okay, so now, but would you use the boot then for the whole 18 hours, or just take...
I probably wouldn't.
Okay.
Just because...
It's too long.
Yeah.
So it's, you put them on, but then what's the longest you have them on, would you say?
I would say 10 hours,
okay.
Maybe 12 of those.
Okay. Okay. If nothing else, we'll...